Hey everybody, before we start this video, I just want to remind you all that if you haven't been over to Kinsey's yet, make sure you go online to kinseysoutdoors.com or visit the store in Mountain Joy for even better deals. They have their giant spring sale April 12th through the 22nd with really good deals on turkey decoys, calls, gear, and even trail cameras and kayaks. So make sure you check it out and get yourself ready for spring. Hey everybody, thanks for checking out another video here in the Kinsey's Outdoors Spring Trout Series. And I'm trying to fight off this cold right now, but it is just an absolutely beautiful day out. I had to get out here and do some trout fishing. And today I am on the Yellow Breeches Creek and I'm just outside of Boiling Springs. This is a beautiful trout stream here in Cumberland County. Right now I am on the catch and release artificial lures only section. Pretty popular creek to fish. They just stocked this creek about, I think, a week or 10 days ago. And the Yellow Breeches also hold some wild brown trout. So maybe I'll get into some of them today even, we'll see. It's about mid-April and the air temp today is in the mid 60s, might even get up into the low 70s today. So just a gorgeous day to be out fly fishing on the creek today. I pretty much have all day to fish. So I'm gonna get after it here. I'm gonna get my rod set up and probably start off with some nymphing. This time of year, we're just now starting to get into a couple of the mayfly hatches here on the Yellow Breeches. And I'll maybe talk a little bit about them later if I see any surface action happening. Parked up here just a little bit, walked downstream. There's a trail here and just gonna fish my way downstream, working these pools, working the runs, and hopefully get into some fish today. All right, guys, so here's my setup today. Got the 10-foot rod out and Orvis Battenkill reel. Here's my bottom fly. I'm gonna run a tandem nymph rig today. My bottom fly there is just an olive beadhead nymph. And then up here, I have a mop fly. I have a split shot in between just to get that down pretty far. And then I have my strike indicator up there. Got some beautiful water right here in front of me. So I think I'm gonna start off in this run here and see if I can't hook into a couple. So one thing that I was just noticing is that, well, obviously the mop fly is very bright. I'm able to see it in the water very well. Could see that it wasn't sinking very well. Like by the time it was getting down deep enough to where the fish are on the bottom, my drift was almost over. Like really my biggest tip for nymphing is that when those fish are feeding on the bottom and you're gonna throw nymphs, you gotta get your flies down deep enough to them. I used to be guilty of that same thing. I'd get lazy. I didn't wanna put split shots on. They would get tangled up in my tippet and I was like, I don't wanna use them. But you get your flies down deep to where the fish are and there's no doubt you're gonna catch more fish. So I'm definitely gonna do that here. Like I was saying, the mop fly, I could see it wasn't sinking fast enough. So I'm gonna get some more split shots on there. So I'm gonna get that down deeper so that I have longer, more successful drifts. So what I'm doing here is just casting up and on an angle, mend the line, get a nice good drift, watch that indicator. When a fish takes that, that indicator is gonna shoot under there real quick and you'll know it when it's a fish. So I'm just working this water out here in front of me, this section, letting it drift down as far as I can until it starts to swing. Throw a couple casts out there farther, mend the line. Just trying to get good drifts every time if we can. Some faster water here in the middle, slower water out there on that side. Makes it a little bit tougher. That different speed in water sometimes gives you an unnatural drift. You gotta do your best. Use your rod, mend your line as best you can.
So I got snagged on the bottom on a rock with my double nymph rig, my mop fly and the olive nymph. Had to snap that off. So I lost those flies. Wasn't getting any hits on that thing anyway. So I think this is a good excuse for me to change it up on my flies. I think I'm going to walk back upstream and just fish the same run that I just fished with those nymphs because it's great looking water. I know there's a lot of fish in here. Just wasn't able to get any on those nymphs. So I think I'm going to put on a streamer. I've had success here previous years with a black streamer. So I think that's what I'm going to try here. Fish this run and hopefully we'll pick up a couple fish here.
So there's a couple different ways you can fish these streamers. Right now what I'm doing is I'm just throwing this thing basically straight across from me and drifting it down through there, swinging it just like I would a traditional wet fly. And I'm letting it swing the whole way down like this until it's straight below me. So there, it's completely below me. I'll pick up and throw again.
Just do the same thing. Drift it down through there. I'll keep increasing my length of the cast out through there to cover this whole pool down through here, down in by those trees too. The other thing you can do is you can strip it in like that, give it a little bit of action. Try and draw a strike from a trout. I'll probably mix it up and try both of them, see what's working. But I really like fishing like this, streamers and traditional wet flies, swinging them downstream. You can really feel those fish hit it hard, and it's a really fun way to catch trout, in my opinion. All right, guys, we're finally hooked up to the first fish of the day on a black streamer. Right down here, he nailed it. Like I was saying earlier, that is a really fun way to catch fish. You can really feel him smoke it. And, I mean, he hit that thing hard. He's fighting pretty good right now. Looks like a rainbow trout. Get my net out here. See if we can get him landed here. There we go. There's a look at him. Not very big, but he fought pretty good. Healthy looking fish, and we'll get him released for somebody else to catch soon.
Well, folks, I'm about to call it quits here. Pretty good day. Landed that one rainbow, nearly landed the first fish of the year on a dry fly. So that was a lot of fun. There's a lot of fish in here, just gotta figure them out. So I'm pretty sure we'll be back sometime soon.
We are here on the Yellow Breaches today in South Central Pennsylvania. We're gonna be fishing this great stretch of water. They just stocked it 6 days ago, so there's a lot of fish. So hopefully we can get into them today. Should be a fun time.
Hooked up with the first fish of the day here. Caught this one on a mop fly. Real nice rainbow. Look at the colors on this fish.
Wow. Nice one.
That's a real healthy fish. That's awesome. We'll get him back. Yeah. Awesome. Awesome fish.
Hooked up with my third fish, real nice brown. I'm on the mop fly again. That's a really pretty fish right there.
About a 13 or 14 inch fish. Beautiful colors. We'll get them back.
There he is, another one. Oh yeah, right there.
Second one of the day, yeah. Got these both on olive scuds. A lot of fun at the Yellow Breaches. Awesome.
Hooked up with number four. This is a nice fish. Real nice rainbow. These fish are so colorful in here. That is beautiful right there.
Jeez. Another nice one.
That's a stud.
Man. It's your third big fish today.
Man, it's huge.
This is a nice fish.
That is beautiful. Get him back. That's dandy.
We're doubled up. We don't know that guy down there, but we're still doubled. Nice. Lots of browns today.
Got a nice brown trout.
caught in there any in a while.
Yeah.
It's been a while. I checked my stuff and my split shot came off. So as soon as I put that split shot on, three casts later.
Let's go.
Caught a fish, so.
They're just laying right out there.
Yeah.
Along that rock wall.
Yep.
And they're rising too.
They are rising. I'm not sure on what, but.
Yeah, we can't figure that out.
Yeah.
But we're catching them on scuds, so.
We're catching them, so. That's all it was. It's a fourth round.
I like 12 inches.
Yeah, for sure.
It's not a fat one, but.
Nice.
Quality fish, though, that's for sure.
Oh, yeah, we'll take it.
This one I got on the midge.
Midge, nice.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a beautiful fish.
Man.
That's a beautiful fish.
Yeah.
Holy smokes.
Yeah, they just got a real nice color on
it. Yeah, it does. That is a tiny fly.
Yeah, look at that, barely hooked. That is nice. It's got really dark.
Yeah.
Dark pink stripe.
Wow.